Hello, I'm Michael Phillips, film critic of the Chicago Tribune. Welcome to TCM's Friday Night Spotlight series, this month devoted to the theme of future shock movies, imagining a future fascinating to visit, but you wouldn't want a one-way ticket there. Tonight's lineup is focused on urban landscapes and the people trying to navigate them. And next, we have one of the grandest, darkest future shock movies of them all, certainly of the last few decades, Terry Gilliam's black comedy, Brazil. The time frame in director Gilliam's movie isn't fixed. Rather, it's a mixture of past and futuristic elements, not to mention lots and lots of conspicuous heating and cooling air ducts. Jonathan Pryce plays our put-upon everyman, Sam Lowry. He's a government employee who dreams of romantic adventure. Then, a clerical error leads to the death of an innocent citizen wrongly accused of terrorism. Lowry does what he can to rectify the problem, only to run into one complication after another and a twisted array of characters. One of them is Robert De Niro, clearly having a great time as a heating and cooling specialist with an interesting sideline. Kim Greist plays the woman in Lowry's daydreams and eventually in his increasingly dizzying real life. The supporting cast is rich with talent, including Bob Hoskins, Michael Palin, Ian Holm, Katherine Hellman, and Jim Broadbent. The movie's kind of like a manic depressive version of George Orwell's 1984, but if anything, Brazil is even bleaker. And yet, with a script by Tom Stoppard, among others, this is one of those pictures that makes you laugh even as it gives you a shudder. I think time has been very good to Brazil. It's become as indelible as the great 1939 song that runs through it. From 1985, Terry Gilliam's Brazil. In so many Terry Gilliam films, the little guy never really has a chance in society, and that's certainly true in Brazil, but there is honor and glory in fighting the good fight, even when the fix is in from the start. Brazil was not an easy sell for a mainstream audience, and Universal Pictures wasn't exactly thrilled with this bleak black comedy. The studio released it in a recut version with a happy ending. Gilliam hated it. So, behind Universal's back, he screened his version for Los Angeles film critics, and when the LA Film Critics Association voted Brazil the best picture of 1985, Universal relented, and Gilliam's cut of the picture made it into theaters after all. Thanks for joining us tonight on our Friday Night Spotlight. I'm Michael Phillips, and I'll be back next Friday with more of TCM's Future Shock Festival.
Tonight on Turner Classic Movies, the director of Kill Bill chats it up in Elvis Mitchell Under the Influence, Quentin Tarantino. Then an actor's actor discusses his inspirations in Under the Influence, Ed Norton. And Gig Young wants Jean Greer to use her assets in You for Me.